Hello everyone, the topic of this video is OSI Reference Model. So, what is OSI Reference Model? The OSI model is a layered framework for the design of the network system that allows communication between all types of computer systems. The purpose of OSI model is to show how to facilitate communication between different systems without requiring change to the logic of the underlying hardware and software. The OSI model is not a protocol, it is a model for understanding and designing a new architecture that is flexible and interoperable. Now, what is OSI? OSI stands for Open Systems Interconnection. That is, every system participating in this model is open for communication with other systems. It was introduced in late 1970s by the International Standard Organization, ISO. The OSI model consists of seven separate but relatable layers, each of which defines a part of the process of moving information across the networks. Following are the seven layers of OSI model: application layer, presentation layer, session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, physical layer. The most common question asked in this particular topic is draw and explain OSI reference model and explain the function of each layer in detail. So as to answer this question, it is necessary to study about the seven layers. A very easy trick to remember the order of the seven layers is to remember this simple sentence: all people seems to need data progress. Where all stands for application, people stands for presentation, S stands for session, T for transport, N for network, D for data link, and P for presentation layer. The first layer is physical layer. It is responsible for actual physical connection between the devices, contains information in the forms of bit. When receiving data, this layer will get the signal received and convert it into zeros and ones and send it to data link layer, which will put the frame back together. The function of physical layer are bit synchronization, bit rate control, physical topologies, transmission mode. Bit synchronization. The physical layer provides the synchronization of the bit by providing a clock. This clock controls both sender and receiver, thus providing synchronization at bit level. Bit rate control. The physical layer also defines the transmission rate, that is the number of bits sent per second. Physical topology. Physical layer specifies the way in which a different device nodes are arranged in a network. Transmission mode. Physical layer also defines the way in which the data flows between the two connected devices. The second layer is data link layer. Data link layer transforms the physical layer, a raw transmission facility, to a reliable layer link. It makes the physical link appear error-free to the upper layer, that is network layer. The few functions of data link layer are framing, physical addressing, flow control, error control, access control. Framing. It provides a way for a sender to transmit a set of bits that is meaningful to the receiver. Physical addressing. Data link layer adds physical address to the sender or the receiver in the header of each frame. Flow control. The data rate must be constant at both sides, else the data may get corrupted. Thus, flow control coordinates that amount of data that can be sent before receiving acknowledgement. Error control. Data link layer provides the mechanism of error control in which it detects and retransmits damaged or lost frames. Access control. When a single communication channel is shared by multiple devices, max sub layer of data link layer helps to determine which device has control over the channel at a given time. The third layer is network layer. The network layer works for transmission of data from one host to another located in different networks. It also takes care of the packet routing, selection of shortest path to transmit the packet from the number of routers available. The sender and receiver IP address are placed in the header by network layer. Some of the responsibilities of network layer include the following: logical addressing, routing. Logical addressing. The physical addressing implemented by the data link layer handles the address problem locally. Routing. When independent network or links are connected to create inter-network or a large network, the connecting devices route or switch the package to the final destination. The next layer is transport layer. The transport layer is responsible for process-to-process delivery of entire message. The transport layer ensures that the whole message arrives intact and in following oversees both error control and flow control at source destination level. The few responsibilities of the transport layer are service point addressing, segmentation and assembling, connection control, flow control, error control. Service point addressing, the layer gets the message to the correct process on the network, unlike network layer, which gets each packet to the correct computer. Segmentation and reassembling, a message is divided into segments. Connection control, a transport layer can be either connectionless or connection oriented. The connectionless transport layer treats each segment as an independent packet. Flow control, like the data link layer, the transport layer is responsible for flow control. Error control, like the data link layer, the transport layer is responsible for error control. However, error control is this layer is performed process to process rather than across a single link. The fifth layer is session layer. The service provided by the first three layers, that is physical layer, data link layer, and network layer, are not sufficient for some processes. The session layer is network dialog controller to establish, maintain, and synchronize the interaction along the communication system. The few responsibilities of the session layer include the following: dialog control, synchronization. Dialog control, the session layer allows two systems to enter into a dialog. It allows the communication between two processes to take place in either half duplex or full duplex mode. Synchronization, the session layer allows a process to add checkpoints or synchronization points to a stream of data. The sixth layer is presentation layer. The presentation layer concerned with syntax and schematics of the information exchange between the two systems. Functions of presentation layers are translation, encryption, compression. Translation, the process in which two systems are usually exchange information in the form of character strings, numbers, and so on. The information must be changed to a bit scheme before being transmitted. Encryption, to carry sensitive information, a system must be able to ensure privacy. Encryption means that the sender information transforms the original signal to another form and sends the resulting message out over the network. The last layer is application layer. Application layer enables the user, whether human or software, to access the network. It provides user interface and support for the service, such as electronic mail, remote file access, transfer, and other type of distribution information services. The function of application layers are mail service, network virtual terminal, directory services, file transfer, access and management. Mail services. This layer provides the basis for email forwarding and storage. Network virtual terminal. It allows the user to log on to a remote host. The application creates software emulation for a terminal at the remote host. Directory service. The layer provides across for global information about various services. File transfer, access and management. It is a standard mechanism to access file and manages it. User can access file in a remote computer and manage it. They can also receive file from a remote computer. Thank you. Hope you understood the topic.